Okay, I am attempting to explain the difference between the types of blogs that you can have in Blackboard. There's the individual blog, which you set up for that where each student has an individual place to write and other people can look at their blogs. There is a class blog in which the whole class sees the same blog and individuals post individual entries in this individual one. This would be like student A posts here, student A posts, student A posts. Now underneath each of these, other students can comment. So every time you have a blog, somebody else can come in and comment. So these are the two sort of normal types of blogs. Then there's another type of blog which is available in the group tools. This is a group blog, and it turns out it's pretty much like a class blog in that when students post, you define your group, and so this may be students 1 through 4. You define your group, and then inside this blog, student 1 can say something, student 2 can say something, student 3, back to student 1, and again, each time, they can comment on each other's, but as you know, they're not actually collaborating here. They are talking asynchronously, but they're not actually collaborating. I think that's partly because a blog is a tool meant for an individual voice, and not a group effort. I also have read, but have not verified, seeing it with my own eyes, that a different group blog, if you have a different group blog, like group 2, these people can see this blog, but not comment. So the only people that can comment in the group blog are the members of that group. But groups can see each other, can see what's going on.